a cold-blooded animal. Their body temperature they can't control. If it's warm outside, then they'll be warm. But if it's cold outside, then they'll be cold. If they need warmth, they'll lie in the sun and rest in the shade. If the heat's too much, most have tough skin with horny scales, which protects them when danger prevails.
Snakes and lizards and alligators too, crocodiles and turtles are in the special group. We call them reptiles, most lay eggs and live on land by swamps or lakes.
Reptile mothers hide their eggs and try to keep them nice and safe. But when the babies hatch, they are on their own to find food, for they are left alone. Reptiles hide from their enemies with camouflaged skin that's brown or green or red or spotted to match the place where they are hiding and trying to keep safe.
Snakes and lizards and alligators too, crocodiles and turtles are in the special group.
Some giant tortoises, I am told, can live to be more than 100 years old. Reptiles use their lungs to breathe. These cold-blooded animals are quite unique, with backbones on the inside of their body. They're a perfect design.
Snakes and lizards and alligators too, crocodiles and turtles are in the special group. We call them reptiles, most lay eggs and live on land by swamps or lakes. We call them reptiles, most lay eggs and live on land by swamps or lakes.
We are going to learn about another group of animals called amphibians. Amphibians are cold-blooded like reptiles, have backbones like reptiles and mammals, but are very different. Amphibians do not have any hair or skin scales on their bodies. They can breathe through their skin as well as through their lungs. And most amphibians spend part of their lives in water. Can you name an animal that's an amphibian?
Frogs and toads are amphibians, and salamanders too. They are all cold-blooded and don't need a lot of food. They like insects and spiders, worms and tasty snails. They'll wait to catch their meal and snatch it without fail.
Amphibians, amphibians, let us name a few. Frogs and toads and salamanders too. They go through metamorphosis, which means they change form.
like eggs in water. When the eggs hatch, they are tadpoles. Tadpoles do not look like frogs, but will change to look more like adult frogs. This is called metamorphosis. When a mammal is born, it resembles its mother, but amphibians need to go through metamorphosis before they will look like their mother.
Their skin is very special for amphibians. We'll use their skin to breathe, just like lungs. What an important tool. You'll find their skin will blend in well with their surroundings. They might be spotted red or be yellow, brown, or green.
Amphibians, amphibians, let us name a few. Frogs and toads and salamanders too. They go through metamorphosis, which means they change form.